We are from Group 3 and we are going to suggest a few modifications to produce a sour soup powder. So the main problem in our study case is there are a problem of low yield in powder production, and then it is not easily reconstituted in water and it forms clumps when it is rehydrated. So there are two modifications that can be made, which is addition of additive, food additive, and there are some, and you can also modify in terms of the processing. Okay, the first modification is by adding food additive, which is maltodextrin. Maltodextrin is a hydrocolloid, which it can facilitate the drying process. It can absorb moisture from the food itself, and then it also increases the transition, the glass transition temperature. The low yield problem, it occurs because the TG temperature for sour soup juice is low, which causes stickiness problem, which forms the clumps, and it sticks to the wall of the chamber, this chamber, during the drying process. The first step that we can do to prevent the problems is by using food additive, which the first one we use maltodextrin. Okay. So maltodextrin, they can solve clumping problems and also increase the yield of sour soup powder. The transition glass transition temperature for sour soup is a bit low because it has high sugar content. So in order to increase the glass transition temperature, we can use maltodextrin so that it will reduce the stickiness and avoid the production of clump and the sour soup powder. And then it can maltodextrin also hygroscopic, which facilitate the drying process. It will absorb moisture from the powder, and the drying process it will be much easier. And then it is also low cost and white in color, so it won't affect the white color of the sour soup powder itself. The next food additive is anti-caking agent. So anti-caking agent will use tricalcium phosphate. Tricalcium phosphate will also avoid clumping between the powder, and it is also white in color, so it won't change the white color of the sour soup itself. Next, we'll proceed to the processing part. So this is the three equipment is for drying process, but we'll add another process which is concentrating process. Concentrating process, it will speed up the drying process. We'll use vacuum evaporator to concentrate up until 50% concentrated sour soup juice. Okay, so why we're choosing vacuum evaporator? Because the cost for vacuum evaporator is a bit high, but it has low maintenance cost, which is beneficial for a long run. Okay, and then it has low operating temperature because our juice is heat sensitive, so it won't cause changes to the fruit juice compound. It is also use low energy consumption, and it can use for aqueous solution, which is suitable for our liquid type of fruit juice. Okay, that's all, and we'll proceed with drying process by Shifa.
Okay, thank you, Vivi. So now I'll be talking about the spray drying process. In this process, the inlet air temperature is 180 degrees Celsius. And in this chamber, we use a concurrent flow dryer because it gives a quick drying, and the outlet temperature is less than 50 degrees Celsius. This means that the powder has no heat degradation. And then the droplets produced with the droplets with highest moisture in contact with air at highest temperature. So, and then after the sprayering process, it will lead to the cyclone. This process is where the separation between air and particles, or air and the soursop powder. And then after the cyclone, I will pass through this pass to the fluidized bed dryer. In this process is the fluidized bed dryer is used to agglomerate the powder. This is to improve the rehydration of the cells of powder. So it will be easily reconstituted in cold water. And then this process is also for further drying. And then for the end product, the powder itself has a moisture content of 1.17%, water activity of 0.19, and total soluble solid of 89.67 risk value. So then the soursop powders are then packaged using a single film. This we use this packaging because it has moisture and gas barrier. And then the anti-caking inside the powder is tricalcium phosphate. The properties of this anti-caking, it has white color and improves the white color of the powder. So that is all from us. Thank you.